Welcome to OpenMentor.net. We are going to see Java arrays. Arrays are nothing but a group of variables with the same name with the different subscript numbers. To define the array or to declare the array, just look at this syntax. Int, this is the basic variable type. We are using square brackets to indicate that it's an array. I have given the array name as arr1. It simply declares an array. It doesn't allocate the elements, number of elements to that. To allocate the number of elements to that, you say array1 is, this is called new operator. The new operator allocates memory. When we say int of 10, an integer is 4 bytes, and we are talking about 10 such elements. So it will allocate 10 into 4, so many bytes, and then allocate that location, storage location, to arr1. So this is one way of declaring the arrays. That means you are specifically giving the number of elements over here and you are giving the data type. Like this, you can give byte array or say float array. This can go on. So you can give any data type, no harm. There is another way to declare array, by initializing the elements itself. So if you see, this is same as the data type to indicate that this is an array. Now the array name equal to, here I am not using new operator, straight away I am giving within curly braces the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 as an example. I am declaring 6 such elements, so automatically it will internally declare 6 storage elements for this arr2. To assign a particular value to an array element is the array name within bracket the subscript, within square brackets the subscripts. Arrays start with the subscript 0. So since we have declared 10, the subscripts will go from 0 to 9. If an array has got 10 elements, the subscript will start with 0, end with 9. So I am initializing 0, 1 and 2, these elements of array 1. I am printing that. Then I am printing array 2's third element. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, right? But this is the subscript 3. So actually in your real life, this is the third element. But when the moment you say subscript 3, subscript 0, subscript 1, subscript 2, subscript 3. Let us execute this program and see what comes out. So this is the first element, this is the fourth element. Let us see here, arr1 of 0, I have initialized to 1, so that 1 is printed over here. Then it prints 7, arr2 of 3, the subscript 3, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, this is the element. So now, I want to know how many elements are present in array2. If you want to find out the length of an array, how many elements are present, you can simply say that array name dot length. If you do this, it will print the number of elements in that particular array. Let us try this out. It says 6. For the arr2 array, there are 6 elements. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let us do one thing. I am going to initialize arr of 7. Let us see what happens. Let us compile it. It compiles. Now I execute. The moment I execute, arr1, anyway I have got 10 elements. Let me do arr of 2, the 7th element. That's why it didn't give any error. Now I am saying, you know very well arr2 has got only 6 elements. Now I am trying to initialize the 7. Let us see what happens. Let us compile. It compiles. When I execute, it is saying array index out of bounds exception at this line. So this is the problem. So the moment you go out of the boundary of the array, you will get into problems. So how to handle these exceptions, we will deal it later. But whenever you are dealing with arrays, make sure that you don't step out of the array boundaries. This is very, very important. Then let us try to copy one array to another array. Let us look at this array declarations. This is array 1, this is array 2. Array 2 has got 6 elements. Now, what I am trying to do is, I am going to copy the content of array 2 to array 1. So, if you look at this array 2, array 2 has got these elements. But if you look at the second parameter, array 2, starting from the second element, copy from array 1's first element, then copy 3 elements from array 2. This is a very important parameter, the last. So, you need not always copy from the 0th location of the first array, source array to target array. This is source array, this is target array. You can copy from any location, but I am specifying copy 3 elements. Then I am trying to print array 1 of 0, 1, 2, 3. Let us see what gets copied over here. Copies 5, 7, 9. Let us take a look at it. This is 0, subscript 0, subscript 1, subscript 2. So, since we have mentioned subscript, start from subscript 2. So, it copied next 3 elements, 5, 7, 9, starting from the subscript of 0 of this array. So, array of 1 has become 5, array 1 of 0 has become 5, array 1 of 1 has become 7, array 1 of 2 has become 9. Since we copied only 3 elements, the 4th element is already 0. So, this is how you can copy array. So, 5, 7, 9 are copied from array 2 to array 1. Why do we need this? We can straight away do an assignment, but here we are copying only 3 elements. But we are using just one line. Whether you are copying 100 elements or 1000 elements, all you need is just one line of code. So, this array copy can copy from source array, from a source subscript, from target array to target subscript, n number of elements. So, this is how you can have array manipulations. But beware, whenever you are dealing with array, don't exceed the array boundary. It will cause problems and exceptions in your program. We will stop the session here.